Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. Joining me this afternoon is Rusty Hutson, CEO at Diversified Energy Company. Rusty, good to see you. How are you?
I'm doing very well. Thank you.
Rusty, lots to get to today. First off, you did announce earlier this week that you had closed a sustainably linked asset-backed securitization for $365 million. Talk to us about the impact of this financing and how the proceeds will be used.
Yeah, well, it's a obviously a very important financing for us, one that we've used in the past. But essentially, it's a way of us being able to match our debt, our financing with our assets, which is long life, low decline assets. These are long-term financings, fixed coupon, under 5%. So we're fixing our cost of debt now for, you know, the sustainable period of time, and gives us real credibility and gives us a lot of visibility into being able to lock in cash flows on those assets. They're hedged out, you know, as I said, and really give us a lot of flexibility and create liquidity on our RBL.
Yeah, and the coupon rate of that ABS is linked to an independent ESG score from Moody's. So what's kind of the relevance of that, do you think, for your shareholders?
Well, I think it helps our shareholders to understand how important ESG is to us and really holding ourselves accountable. So by being able to, you know, tie that to a sustainability type situation from an ESG perspective, it lets our shareholders know, hey, we're taking this seriously. We're monitoring our numbers. We're making sure our numbers stay in place and where they should be so that we keep that low coupon.
Moving to that, to the big news of the day, you did issue your full year trading update today. What were some of the kind of key takeaways from that release?
Yeah, I think, you know, overall, just the fact that we obviously 2021 was trading in line with expectations, which is important for our shareholders to know that, you know, prior to the actual earnings release later in the quarter. You know, expenses, you know, all good numbers around, you know, in terms of expenses and margins staying, you know, at the 50% level and higher. Also, keeping our leverage in check and our leverage profile staying in that 2.1 times range. And then also a really robust update on all of our ESG initiatives and the capital that we're spending to lower our emissions, which we committed to back in November at our Capital Markets Day, and the fact that we just acquired more asset retirement crews with an acquisition of a smaller plugging company there in Pennsylvania, which will give us more leverage to be able to do more wells, plug more wells, and then also be able to plug wells for third parties to help cover the cost of our own plugging.
Yeah, speaking of acquisitions, you had quite an active year with entry through an acquisition of a new basin. So talk about how those acquisitions are going and kind of what sort of synergies you think you'll realize from them.
Yeah, very important acquisitions in that new region, central region. We closed four in 2021. So significant growth there. Three of those were with our partner, Oak Tree Capital. And so, you know, obviously good deals from their perspective also. But really the size and scale is so important to us. And as we grow the company, we get the size, we get the scale that's necessary to drive synergies and efficiencies in the business, drive down unit cost, increase margins. But the real benefit of that central region is the fact that we now have access to a much more robust gas market, natural gas market than Appalachia has been, with prices that are much closer to Henry Hub with less differentials that we have to factor into our net gas price.
And in terms of macro themes, we are seeing commodity prices remain strong right now. So how do you think this impacts your business outlook? And what do you think it means for Diversified's hedging policy?
Well, you know, we've been rolling in new hedges. And so as you'll see in our trading update, that our net effective pricing on a going forward basis is moving up, because our hedges are that we're putting on are at a higher price. And so that's having an impact on our overall net revenues and helping us to continue to drive up revenues from that perspective. But the macro's strong. We think commodity prices will remain strong in the foreseeable future. And I think capital discipline has restored itself in the industry. So I don't expect people to go really crazy with the drilling rigs and really, you know, look to do what they would have done 5 or 10 years ago. which would have been to drive production too high, which would have had an opposite effect on prices. So I think we're in a good place right now.
So now in terms of the kind of current market landscape, what does that look like in terms of your ability to continue this kind of growth that you've been on for acquisitions?
Oh, the acquisition market is as strong as I've ever seen it. We have multiple opportunities that we're looking at all times, both upstream and midstream. You know, we have the ability to be very selective now and make sure that everything that we look at and that we end up moving on fits the model at the right valuation and has long-term value accretion to our shareholders. And so we have the ability to do that. We have capital, and you know, we think that the sky's the limit right now in terms of the ability to continue to grow the company.
That's great to hear, Rusty. Really good to get an update from you. Appreciate it. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much.